broadcast or use of any recording device is strictly prohibited. Thank you. And now, please welcome to the stage, Lauren Elder. Allison, Guinn, and Maya Sharpe. Thank you.
cold showers every day. Tired as hell, you're away. I wish that I could say I wanna make you mine, be with you all the time. I could hear you say, hey, hey, I'm in love with you. Hey, hey, I hope you feel it too. 'Cause you know that I really do. Hey, hey, just don't be afraid of all the magic that we made.
Opportunity and art and theater and steel.
But see, the thing is that I knew I wasn't going to focus my energies on boys that grew up to be gay. Right? I was going to focus on being a performer. So, in Pittsburgh, high school shows are a really big deal, and they let the younger kids audition if they have, like, children's parts. So, this year, I was in fifth grade, and they were doing The King and I. So, I told my mom I have to go. So, we went, and there were hundreds of kids there. And my little sister is sick, and she's crying. And my mom looks at me and she goes, "Honey, there are so many kids here, and let's just go home." And I said, "No, you go home. I'm staying. I'm gonna get this." And I did. And that's when she knew that there was, like, no way that this was not happening. So this was what I was going to do for a living. And I was starring in The King and I. Just everything was magical. Oh. I always wanted to see the lights of Broadway. I always wanted to hear the traffic roar. I always wanted to be a part of North Allegheny High School's great big heart. Now I am, I couldn't ask for more. So, I was in The King and I, and I found out about this amazing performing group called the North Star Kids. They did the Thanksgiving parade every year in Pittsburgh. Pittsburgh Thanksgiving parade. But I had to be a part of it. So I went to audition, and at the auditions, you had to make up your own dance, and I had not taken dance lessons, even though I asked for them all the time. I don't know why. But it was okay. I didn't need dance lessons because I watched MTV all the time. I had my dance idols like you know, Madonna and Paula Abdul. Lost. And I dream. Don't know. Way too slow. Okay. So, let's see. My made-up choreography didn't cut it, and I got cut. I didn't get in. I know, even after that, right? So I tried again the next year, and they didn't put me in the next year. But then when I was 12 and over 5 feet tall and developing boobs, and like the most awkward thing ever, they put me in that. Thanks, guys. But you know, after conquering that, I kind of started to feel stifled and in a bubble. And we packed up and we said, say goodbye to old Pittsburgh. And we moved to Santa Cruz, where you can meet anybody you want to be. You can. And, you know, like many things, Santa Cruz was not exactly what it promised to be. The high school had no theater department. What? Right? And there were no cute boys. Nope, I didn't need boys. I needed to perform. So, me being me, I just kind of missed Pittsburgh, I guess, is really where we were. I missed Pittsburgh because I could perform there. So, let's sing a song about that.
Yep.
Reno Sweeney at age 16. And then at age 17, I conquered another great role. A boy like that will kill your brother. Get the boy and find another. None of your own kind, stick to your own kind. Sang a white girl. I literally tanned all summer to play that part. I still was not in the dark room. But in rehearsal, I met a boy. He played action. So he was a shark. Or he was a jack. I was a shark. Was I really a Maria? Oh, he was older. It was a true showmance. And I found out that he was boring. No, he wasn't gay. He was boring. It's like, just bad. So we broke up with him. And then a few years later, I saw him walking down the street, and he literally ran away from me. I know. I felt really bad, and that made me kind of think, like, well, what if he was the one? What if I shouldn't have just let him go because he was boring? I mean, doesn't everybody kind of think about that kind of stuff? Looking at Facebook, at your exes, you know you all do it. Wondering, did I miss the one? The night is bitter. The stars have lost their glitter. The room grows colder. Suddenly you're older, and all because of the man that got away. No more his eager call, the writing's on the wall. Run off then and done you. The great beginning has seen its final ending. Don't know what happened. It's just a crazy looking for the man. I really do try not to focus my life on frivolous relationships. Instead, I focus on my friends and my family. All of you in this room. Thank you so much for being here. Like in Santa Cruz, I've made my own opportunities for me and my friends, and that's what I love to do, like these concerts, and, you know, I got to play all these amazing roles, and it was because I wanted to express all these things. I wanted to show that I could be Reno, and I could be Anita, and I could be Audrey in Little Shop. I got to play her too. That was so amazing. And I wanted to show that I could do anything. I could be whoever the casting director wanted, or whoever the director wanted, or whoever I wanted. So that brings me to my next song.
streetlight outside her window, where the couples kiss goodnight. But it's just soul-searching and think about what was going on.
I really missed New York, and I thought, what is it about theater that I love so much? It's just like the greatest thing ever. It's where you can kind of be a weirdo, you know? I am a weirdo deep down inside, and I always wanted to kind of push the envelope and be like, hey, look at me! And I would wear weird costumes to school to see if anybody would say anything. And I've always kind of felt, you know, at home with kind of the weirdos, and I guess that's part of what theater is, you know? It's like where we can all be a weirdo and not be pushed, judged for it, not there's things happening on my stage. Oh, you're great, Bob Joy, my ladies and gentlemen. This is Bob Joy. You may know we're not going there. See, the thing is that in theater, we're all a little weird because we're all kind of freaks. Broadway, and Maya was also at that open call, which is so crazy. But we didn't know her yet. But then we were all in the same dressing room, and we would all sing together in the dressing room. And then we went to Broadway, and we would sing together in my apartment around the corner. And then we went to London, and we would sing together there. And now we sing together here again. We just never saw each other. I'm scared, Daisy. So I called Haven when that horrible week happened. Honey, she knows what it's like to close Broadway shows, and before the show closes, usually. If I'm jumping ship, you better get out of there. She's got a sixth sense about those things. Yeah, watch out. Anyway, so I called Haven and we have a little chat. Oh God. Hit it, band.
You just met him. Yes, I know. This is lasting. This will grow. But hope it's never that easy. Believe me, it isn't at all. You were starstruck. So was I. I would love him. But oh, it's never
stage and I came back and this is my encore because it's not really a backstage, so yeah, that was enough applause. We're gonna bring these ladies back up here. Haven, do you wanna sing on this too? You don't have to, but you can if you want. We're bringing her back. Okay, so a couple of years ago after Hair closed in London, I was kind of in a place where I just didn't know what I was doing. I needed to create something for myself, and I started writing songs on a ukulele, and it was just something totally different than performing in theater and TV and auditions and things. This was for me, and I shared my songs with some of my friends, and they liked them, and so I started playing in like small little cafes and bars, and then gigs got a little bigger, and I got to play Joe's Pub, and now here I am at 54 Below! Yeah. Yeah. This is my song, Wintry Vacation. Yeah.